sign. Uh-huh. They will have the money sign as the S.
Yeah. That's the only way to do it.
So that stretch runs past Fremont High, and that is where Too Short graduated. Oakland City Council will vote on the name change next week. And let's talk about some of the most underrated Christmas gifts. So people have been voting online, and they're all pretty practical gifts, but these are some of the top underrated gifts, okay? Extra phone chargers.
Oh,
you can never have enough. Even when I think I have too many, I can never find them.
Oh, that's such a good gift.
And you gotta have the butts. That's what I'm always missing.
Yeah, yeah.
Blocks. Nikki called it a butt one day, and it stuck.
You're welcome.
Nice sheets and nice towels.
Yes. Definitely
great.
On the list.
Yep, bamboo all day, baby. A premium subscription to something like maybe Spotify or HBO Max.
Or like Wine.com. Something like that. That'd be great.
You don't have to give me a new gift. You can just give me your password for all your subscriptions.
What a great idea.
Yeah, just give to me your password.
But I love that this made the list for one of the top underrated Christmas gifts, a giant pack of toilet paper.
That would have been hot in 2020.
Yeah.
I don't know. It would be a great gift.
Today's on the list. Today is on the list.
Socks. Socks is a great gift.
I think so too. Once you hit a certain age, a nice pair of underwear or a nice pair of socks goes a long way.
That's what y'all are all getting from me.
Sassy sport.
An arrest warrant has been issued for ex-NFL star Antonio Brown after he threw a shoe at the mother of his chicken earlier this week. He's a class act, isn't he? Tampa police showed up at Brown's Florida residence while he was in an altercation with a woman whom he has several children with. Brown also threw the woman's belongings out onto the street and kicked her out of the house. But cops could never get Brown to come out, so they advised the victim to leave, which she did, and spend the night somewhere else. But they left Brown there, barricaded in his house. This isn't like in the movies and TV, they go in after him, right? They don't just let you say, sorry, you can't come in.
Good thing he wasn't here, because, you know, we got those robots, and they walked right in there.
Well, cops just left him in there, and now no one knows where he is, but there is an arrest warrant out for him. The Los Angeles Lakers aren't very good, but their fans seem to be amazing. Two fans in the last week hit mid-court shots during in-game promotions to score huge paydays. Last week, a dude hit a shot that scored him $75,000. And then half-court shot resulting in a $25,000 payday.
All right, Benny, it is your time to show off that shot you got that you practiced in junior high.
Underhanded.
Oh, underhanded three-point king right here. All day, baby.
Well, sign up. They do this kind of stuff at the Warriors game. Okay. So sign up online. And a big weekend of sports headed your way. Tomorrow morning, 7 a.m., Team USA takes on the Netherlands to advance in the World Cup. Bars will be full super early. So if you want to watch with Nikki, where are you going to be?
Greg, you're going to be right next to me. What are you talking about?
If you want to watch with the masses, you're going to need to set your alarm and get up early. And Sunday, a big test for the 7-4 49ers. They host the 8-3 Miami Dolphins. And the Raiders, they'll try to go for their third straight win, hosting the LA Chargers. That's all I got for Sassy Sports. But you know what I would say? If they're playing with balls, I'm all over it.
Entertainment Report.
It was yay day yesterday. Kanye over the internet with his wild antics again. It started with him saying that he liked Hitler during an interview and ended with him tweeting saying that he caught NBA star Chris Paul with Kim Kardashian. He also shared his text conversation saying that Ye has gone too far and this is not love. And that was in response to one of the photos that Kanye had put up on Twitter.
I'm so done with this guy. I was done with him 6 months ago. And I don't understand why we keep giving him a platform. I mean, I know we're talking about him, but I'm interviews. Why are people allowing him to do interviews?
Interview yesterday. Alex Jones, who is the scummiest of scum, the bottom barrel of the earth.
But we need to stop giving this dude a platform.
I agree. But you know what's crazy is when Alex Jones is even taking a step back with some of the things that Kanye was saying, it was wild. And then the kicker at the end of the night, I saw that tweet go out when he was talking about it. It made my jaw jaw drops.
So Chris Paul plays for the Phoenix Suns.
Yes.
He's saying he caught Kim
and him together. ABC will not discipline Good Morning America co-hosts Amy Robach and TJ Holmes for their secret affair. They're saying that since they're both consenting adults on the same level in the company, that is okay.
I agree.
I agree.
We're all assuming that they were cheating on their partners, but we don't know if they had separated or stopped talking behind closed doors with their husband and their wife. We don't know.
So they were going to go public with their relationship once Amy's divorce was final, so I think that plays a big part, too, that they were ready to talk about this. Somebody just caught them earlier.
And did y'all see who her ex-husband is? He was on Melrose Place.
The original Melrose Place?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Like, I thought it was Shoe or something. Yeah. Elizabeth Shoe. It's her brother.
Interesting. And Emancipation is out today in theaters. That's Will Smith's first movie since The Slap. He plays a runaway slave who escapes from an abusive Louisiana plantation and joins the Union Army. This film already about this.
A lot of Oscar talk. Will did an interview and he's like, this isn't a slave movie. This is a freedom movie. Mm-hmm. I would never do another slave movie because there's so many of them. He said, this is a freedom movie.
Okay, and I'm confused again on this, but I think I have it right. So he could win an Oscar, but he can't go to the Oscars?
Correct.
Mm-hmm. And if you don't want to see it in theaters, it will be on Apple TV Plus December 9th. So you can watch it at home. Hey, are you going to go to
I'm going to wait a week.
Okay.
All right, best and dirty on the 30. What do you say? Shall we give away these tails? Everybody wants them, and we have them. Here's what you have to do. You have to text us right now with the keyword Midnights. Midnights with an of course, that is the name of Taylor's album. Text Midnights to 888-456-9999. And you could be seeing Taylor Swift next summer. Love Trap is on the way.
Corey thought when he and his girlfriend Natalie moved in together, they would grow closer. But now she says she needs her space. Corey is worried that she might be pushing him away because she's spending time with another man. So we're going to set the love trap on her next with Vinny, Nikki, and Greg on Big Bay Mornings.
Right.
John,
this is Big Bay Mornings.
Kicking it with the morning show.
I love you guys so much.
99.7 now.
Get 50% off sweaters for the whole family. Grab cozy sweaters for everyone on your list for 50% off. But hurry, it's this Saturday only at Old Navy and OldNavy.com. Valid December 3rd, select styles only.
It's the season of giving back. That's why Kia is expanding our partnership with St. Jude Children's Research Hospital and making a donation for every eligible new car purchase during the holidays through Kia's Accelerate the Good program. Kia, movement that inspires. Kia will donate $8 for every new Kia vehicle that is purchased or leased at authorized Kia dealerships and delivered to retail customers between November 11, 2022 and December 31, 2022, with a guaranteed minimum donation of $1 million to the Children's Research Hospital. See kia.com/seasonofgivingback for details.
Your local grocery outlet has all the name brands you love, all at amazing low prices. This week, get a great deal on chicken. Sanderson Farms boneless, skinless chicken breast family packs are just $1.79 a pound. That's a savings of up to 40% versus traditional grocery stores. Also, make snack time fun with Funnables fruit snacks. DC Super Pets or Trolls varieties are just $1.99 each. That's a savings of up to 75%. Offers good through December 6th.
Grocery outlet, bargain market.
This is Greg from Big Bay Mornings. Frozen, the hit Broadway musical, is now on stage at San Francisco's Orpheum Theater through December 30th. The San Francisco Chronicle gave Frozen their highest rating, calling it dazzling. And right now, there are great orchestra seats starting at $75 extra fees. I had a blast at Frozen, and I know you will too. So get your tickets for Frozen at BroadwaySF.com.
Including that apple cider and Hardy into the X, Xfinity Black Friday sales. St. John Air 99.7. Stream your heart out with the ultimate streamer setup. Right now, new Xfinity customers can get 400 megabits internet with unlimited data and XFi complete for just $55 a month for 24 months with no annual contracts and a free 4K streaming box included too. Plus, for a limited time, get HBO Max included for 1 year so you can stream HBO Original, Succession, and the the White Lotus. So drop everything, get to the Xfinity Black Friday sale right after December 5th. Go to xfinity.com. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit an Xfinity store today.
Restrictions apply. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Taxes and fees extra. Ad supported plan of HBO Max. After promo, regular rates apply to all services and devices.
Hey, singles. Want the best recipe for your holidays? Get cooking. Start with a pint of excitement, add a cup of fun, a dash of flirtiness, and even a pinch of spice. Mix it up, and you've got the single life you've always wanted. From Events and Adventures, members enjoy over 30 exciting events each month, like live band karaoke, axe throwing, or salsa dancing. The best part? Everyone is single. Don't miss out. Get started today. Single during the holidays? Don't forget to treat yourself this holiday with an amazing party, indoor skydiving, or wine tasting. Events and Adventures has been providing fun and create friendships and spark new relationships for over 30 years. The best gift this season is the one you give yourself with Events and Adventures. Get started today at Events and Adventures.
If you're hurt in an accident, don't just hire anyone. Get the care you need and money you deserve. Voted best attorneys in America. Pay nothing until they win. Call 800-500-5200 or sweetjames.com.
Any other guys do this or am I the only one?
You're listening to Big Bay Morning.
Good day, sir. Yes.
Oh, the morning to you.
Big Bay Morning's home of the love trap. Corey thought that when he and his girlfriend moved in together, they would grow closer. But instead, she says that she's worried that she might be pushing him away to spend time with another man. So we're going to call her next and set the love trap.
Cheater. for setting the love trap on 99.7 Now. And Corey's calling about his girlfriend, Natalie. What's up, Corey? Natalie creeping or what?
Hey, guys. I mean, no, I don't know, but it's like, I feel like something is up. Okay, so here's the deal. We moved in together recently, just a couple months ago, and yeah, and I thought she was psyched, and, you know, first, that was awesome. But it's weird because, I mean, kind of pretty quickly, stuff feels different. I thought, like, when we moved in together, it was really gonna, we were gonna, like, be and everything. But, it's actually kind of been, I mean, I don't want to say the opposite, but stuff is different. She's doing this thing where, this bugs me. She goes, I need my space, and I need my private time, whatever.
How soon, like, after she moved in did she start this?
Like, less than a month.
If she needed her space, then why did
she in? Like, no, I would say, and that's why, because it's like my first time living with somebody, too, and her, too. And so I'm like, it doesn't sound crazy to be like, oh, I need a little private time and stuff. I'm like, cool, I think, but it's like she's always going out without me with her, you know, not coming, you know?
So are you not ever invited when she goes out with her girlfriends?
No. No. Okay. And she's like, well, you have your friends, so let me do my thing. Like, we don't need to see each other every second of every day. And I get that, but, you know, it's
kind of rude.
Yeah, your girl's a cat.
Yeah. It comes with, like, you want to spend time with your girl, and now you're not spending time with her at home and not spending time outside of the house.
But the fact that you guys just moved in together and she's trying to be away from the house, that's weird.
It is.
You think she'd be super excited to be at the house with you.
Right.
And, okay, so here's what is, like, really troubling me. A couple weekends ago now, she tells me she's going to a bachelorette party with a girl, and they were spending the night there. Well, so I trust her. Okay. Because my friend is. A couple days after that, we're sitting there watching TV. It was like Thursday. She's going to her phone and stuff. I look over. I see her. There's a picture. A selfie of her with some guy. Like, they're hugging up in a bed with champagne.
I'm sorry. And,
yeah.
Are they just sitting on a bed with their clothes on? Or are they in bed together?
Their clothes are on. But they're hugging, but there's champagne, and they're on a bed. So it's like,
okay.
I did freak out. No, he's my gay friend. He's the one gay friend that got invited to the party, the bachelorette party, and her thing is like, we're just the first two that got there to the hotel that night.
But then let me see some other photos with the gay friend and the rest of the girls when you guys are all out and about.
I said that pretty much that exact thing. I'm like, all right, prove it. And she's like, well, then, you know, her friend Megan came. This is the main girl. And then it, like, really kicked off. And then her friend was like, no phones. She has some, like, no phones rule, which I get. But it's like, you got the one photo of you and the guy, and there's nobody else. So it looks bad for you.
Starting to look to find out if he is who he, like, who she says he is.
And no photos means no photos. So then why would there be a photo?
They were there first.
Wasn't no lie.
Yeah, no.
Red flag.
Y'all are all mad.
I don't care what story she's making up. The fact that you had to see that and she's trying to,
You know, you don't want to hear this, but we'll tell you right now. She's cheating.
For sure.
Whatsoever of this bachelorette weekend. Not on social media, not on her phone, someone else's phone.
No. But I mean, like, and here's what I think. Like, I am holding that hope that there is, like, really an explanation. Because
let's find out.
Let's get to it. We'll play a song. As soon as it's over, friend, and we'll go from there, okay?
All right, cool.